Blog Talk Radio.
It's time to get up and get your praise on with the Turntable Minister, DJ Mike Cummins. DJ Mike Cummins. DJ Mike Cummins.
You're listening to the Love Radio Network worldwide. LoveRadioNetwork.com. Educational, inspirational, trending topics, and the hottest hits.
And the hottest hits.
With award-winning talk show hosts and personalities. And you made us number one. Thank you. Love Radio Network, building a network of love.
My goodness, hump day was fantastic, and guess what? Today is Thursday, and it's even better. So welcome, welcome to all our friends and family and guests to a single woman's love show here on Love Radio Network that is now streaming live 24 hours at Love Radio Network 24. If you're not part of the team or the family, go to LUV Radio Network 24. Go ahead, join up, and so that you can hear all of the newest and the latest and the greatest with our internet radio show and host. Now, I am your worldwide radio host for this show tonight, A Single Woman's Love, and I'm Miss Simone, and I'm coming to you live thanking you for your time and for tuning in to share yourself with me tonight. It is a great day to be empowered and to actually learn a new perspective while learning something new, of course, having that capacity to grow. That's what it's all about, y'all. So if you're new to A Single Woman's Love show, we say welcome, welcome. Call on in and enjoy the show. If you are a reoccurring or dedicated listener, we say thank you and bless you for your dedication, all of your time and effort for being here on Thursday night, enjoying, of course, ladies' night, as well as myself that starts at 7 o'clock, and then I'm here at 7:30. Now, thank you all to those who listened in on A Single Woman's Love new show, Couch Chronicles, that airs on Wednesday nights at 9 p.m. We had a fantastic show. You can go to Love Radio Network 24 and actually go catch up on all of the different shows that you kind of missed, and then that way you'll be able to participate or have any questions that you have going forward. Now, in the meantime, ladies and gentlemen, call or text your friends and family to come on in. Join us by logging on to LUVRadioNetwork.com. Go ahead and press that live button. You can't miss it. Or you can actually call into the show at 563-999-3519. And that's 563-999-3519. And press that one button. We can also listen at 727-731-5250. Again, that's 727-731-5250. Come on in. Remember, you can connect with me on Facebook and Instagram at Symone Hurt. It's S-Y-M-O-N-E, last name Hurt, H-U-R-T. Nothing else fancy, nothing else special. If you see any dashes, any dots, or whatever, that's not me. So I'm just saying, it's just simple and plain as can be. I'm an old lady, and that's how I like it. So I hope that you can go ahead and connect with me. If you send me a friend request, I will befriend you back so you can be part of the updates for A Single Woman's Love show. And, of course, ladies' night. Hallelujah. Okay, now, praying everyone is well today and staying safe. Now, don't forget to love yourself on top of that. Now, we got a great topic tonight. Now, today we have a very special guest who is rising above all odds, y'all. I got me a wild Mustang on the show tonight. I'm just going to tell you, she's about to bring it, and she's about to teach you some stuff as well. So just make sure you settle down, listen to Nestle-in, and make sure that you are listening, my loves. Oh, my God. So we're going to, normally I have an intro. I'm cutting the intro. We got too much to talk about tonight, so we're just going to bring her on here. I am so happy, so pleased to have Miss Veronica Gonzalez on our show tonight. Welcome in, my love. How are you, Miss Gonzalez?
I'm doing so great. Thank you for having me.
What's up? Oh, my God. Girl, that's what I'm talking about. We're going to keep it like that. That's all right with me. What's up, baby girl?
Awesome.
How are you doing?
I'm doing great. I've just been here and there, but I just wanted to just summon up to you guys, and I just Thank you so much for having me on right now. Thank you.
Yes. I'm just so happy that we got an opportunity to actually connect. You are what I call one of my 360-degree entrepreneurs.
Thank you.
Yes, baby, you made the club, so I'm just saying. It's all good. And it takes a whole lot to come on board and join that club of mine because simply, you know, you have to give a lot of yourself. It isn't just a 9-to-5. It isn't just this. You got to be able to turn on a pivot on a dime, and you got to make sure you make it happen. And you have definitely met those criteria to be in that club. So I say thank you, and welcome. How was your? Let's start slow and easy. We're going to start this slow and easy. I'm on this new Tina Turner thing. You know, I like to start things slow and easy, and then we're going to make it rough a little later.
That's fine.
Okay. So how you been doing today? How's your week going?
Actually, well, I've been here and there, just doing a lot of things lining up for next week, just doing a lot of stuff, and I'm just actually studying some things. I'm hoping you see that I'm going to show tonight on some projects we're actually releasing this week with docu films and new music on the way for this month.
Okay. Well, I'm going to give you the spotlight for a moment. I'm going to let you just go ahead and introduce yourself to the audience. I want you to tell them the name of your business and just tell about yourself just a little bit. We're going to get into a little deep about some other stuff, but just give them a little idea of who you are and why you're here, honey, and why you are important, because you know you're an important queen. So go ahead and put your crown on.
Thank you so much.
You're welcome.
Not a problem. So first and foremost, I'm an artist, author, poet, screenwriter. Oh gosh, I do also TV and radio as well as host. I don't have time off. I do it all. I try to, if I can, I'm also an entrepreneur. I have my own production called Vero G Productions, which basically provide a platform for all independent artists out there, all genre, of course, to have their time to shine. We just made our 2-year mark for the TV show, and we've been just branching out, and right now, we're actually not on Roku TV. We're also on Amazon Fire TV as well. You guys can find us at Vero G Spotlight TV Network. We're also on YouTube. My YouTube channel is Vero G Spotlight TV Network. You guys can subscribe. I will subscribe back as well. And basically, like I said, you know, I do a lot for community-based work. We just did a back-to-school event at Small this year. I believe it was around like late August or so. And it was just an incredible moment for me and my team. Big shout-out to Gemini Stack, Empire Media, and everyone who and DJ Chase as well. And everyone who partakes in our mission, what we do is just giving back and just being the hardest people that we do. And overall, I just feel like, you know, it's a lot of stuff to say tonight, but I feel like overall what we're doing is just incredible because we get the feedback from everyone who's been part of our mission, either with the music, either for the platform to provide for radio TV, or also for the magazine as well. We're just giving back and helping people at these times, especially with sometimes with COVID. I feel like we more than ever should be unified and united and help one another, pushing and working and just be positive for everyone out there listening to your listeners tonight. You know, just what we do, our platform is just to provide amazing stuff you guys to be a part of. Okay, so also as well besides that, project right now, just finished right now wrapping it up. As we speak next week, actually on October 13th, it will be officially released, the docu-film, which is one of the docu-films I work with director James Pioneer Media, alongside with producer Sheena Gordine on the domestic violence docu-film, which is called Through Their Eyes, The Mask Behind the Mask. And I'm so honored that it will be released next week on Tuesday, which is on the streaming October 13th, and that'll be around 8 p.m. or so. We're going to have it on worldwide, Roku, YouTube, Amazon Fire TV, and it's amazing. Show all basically about survivors who survived domestic violence and their story and reveal how they overcame it, and maybe some of whoever's going to watch could be inspired by.
Okay. Well, hold on one second. Veronica, just a check in with you. Are you on speaker?
Yes.
Okay, let's come off the speaker because I can't hear you as clearly as I could possibly.
Okay, sure.
All right, there we go. So that's what I'm talking about.
Okay.
That makes it up close and personal.
Oh, okay.
There you go.
No
go,
problem.
Okay, I got you, but I'm struggling to get you now.
It's
no
okay.
problem.
Okay.
Well, that is
Thank
fantastic,
you.
Honey. You got a Thank lot going on. I that's why I just love you. You have you
Thank
make it
you.
Happen, and I have no problem with that. But let's just break this down just a little bit for some people so
okay.
that we can be a little bit more spotlighted on certain particular things. Now, you
okay.
wrote a book called Trials and Tribulations. Is that correct?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah.
Yes.
Give me a couple minutes on tell me why what's your book about and why you wrote that.
Sure. Okay. So I written that book around over 2 years ago. In fact, I at that time I was going through some personal things, and I feel like, you know, I have a testimony. I have to tell my story. So at that moment, I written that book around within 3 days back to back. I written it and I started just putting the process together and everything, and then it just got released, I think, last year or so. And I believe, if I'm not mistaken, I think it's still available at Manhattan Community College. That's in the Bronx. If I'm not mistaken, but I don't know if they still have it there. But the book itself basically is going through things I went through, also being a domestic violence survivor, being a rape victim, being in the foster care system, also being homeless and pregnant, going through all these ordeals in my life and how to manage to overcome it. And now to this day, you know, to provide a platform for people and to inspire them to, you know, basically what's the ultimate business as being, you know, out there, all upcoming or independent artists out there, they need a platform to be, you know, at home. They feel like they're comfortable and they have a place where they can shine, and that's what we provided for them 2 years now with the brand.
You're right.
For the
great, great. That's great. Now, you and I, we were talking before, we definitely connected on the simple fact that I have also gone through domestic violence as well. And I was very, very touched by your story. And definitely, you know, this is a book. Now, where did you say that you can get this book at again?
Yes. Okay. For now, I know for sure it's definitely available at www.amazon.com.
Okay.
It's just type of Trials and Tribulations and Autobiography of Vero G, and basically it's a really great book. I'm not just saying because I wrote it, but it's really something that I put my heart dedication to, and I feel like I really opened myself up to anyone who gets a chance to get a copy of the book. It's something that it could inspire them or know somebody who's gone through the things I went through and to maybe help them and this is this time.
Yes, definitely. Now, what would you like the audience to actually know about domestic violence? What would you like to bring home in a couple minutes just to let people know and be interested in reading the book?
Sure. Overall, I feel like domestic violence, especially now that we have to stay in and with the COVID situation, I truly feel domestic violence is something that it shouldn't be of a joking manner, in the sense what I'm saying is, like, the law, they don't really put into effect or something stronger and force something to the abusers out there, either male or female, to the victims, forgive me. And I just feel like domestic violence itself is something that it shouldn't happen, because, you know, you shouldn't put your hands on your loved one to prove a point or trying to control them or manipulate them or any way or any matter, you know. And you know, especially this, like, this month, the Domestic Violence Awareness Month, I feel more than ever as an advocate, I have to keep reminding people either way I can, like, listen, we have to really stay focused on this. And this is so many women and men are killed every day. The numbers are going higher because of COVID. They can't leave their homes. And I feel like we need, as everyone who's listening now, your viewers or your listeners are listening, I just want those out there to know, help your friend if they're going through it. If it's a silent killer, you have to let them know. You know, if your friend is close to you, then you go, those that's going through or so forth, don't judge them. Help them before they become statistics. You don't need that down the line, because
this is true.
Their lives could be saved. Yeah, and I'm rambling now, but it's just feel like something very. No,
it is. It's very touching,
Thank
sweetheart,
you.
And it's okay. It's going to be okay. You know,
Thank
don't
you.
Forget that you've survived this. You've made it through.
Yes.
You
oh,
know,
God, yes,
so that's what I'm the other queen, honey. I'm trying to tell you, get your crown, straighten it out. It's okay. It's gonna be okay, sweetheart. It is. It really, really is. You know, and people, I touch bases on this a lot with my friends when we discuss a lot of different topics, and people are always amazed that you went through domestic violence. Yes, because you know sometimes you can get into domestic violence just loving somebody too hard.
Yes.
You know, and yes. Just because it's not the best healthy way to love them, but you just love them to death, and you let them get away with things they don't need to be getting away with, and it just takes a wrong left turn, and it goes a wrong way, literally. Domestic violence isn't something that is just random. You know, it is because you're with someone that does not know how to manage themselves and their emotions, period.
Yeah.
Or they've been taught, you know, a lot of times domestic violence has been taught, and it's not even from the male side. It's also, I've seen a lot of cases with females that they have been charged with domestic violence. So let's keep that real out here, okay? There are some men, and I know it's hard for the men to talk about because they feel a little bit more shame to it than because of the situation being reversed. But there's a lot of aggressive women who have seen other aggressive women out here getting away with a lot of things and think that they can get away with that as well. The whole bottom line is we need to be loving each other instead of putting our hands on each other. We have to
That's
learn how
right.
to effectively communicate. And we have to learn how to manage ourselves because this is where it all starts with. We're not managing ourselves properly. And so, therefore, you can't be trusted to be managing other people when you can't manage yourself.
Yeah.
So, yeah. You know, but let's talk about your entrepreneurship, you know, your
yes.
business right now. It's booming, girl. Go ahead and tell me about it. Go ahead and give it
to me. Okay, it's a lot. Okay, all right. So, you know, I'm just honored to, like you mentioned before, I really rarely sleep. I'm always working. I need to, you know, you have to be on top of your A game. You have to constantly make, you know, be new content, be creative and stuff. It's really hard, but... Overall, I feel fulfilled, you know, with the production, Vero G Productions. You know, it's been actually, I think it's over 2 years now, I believe, or a year or so with the production. And I think it's just a great thing to see it blossom. And, you know, we do a lot. We do from, because I also work with my business partner, Jam Prime Media, where we do promotions.
Okay, slow down, because they missed that, because I know I missed that, girl. Come on now. Let's back that up.
Okay.
Who's your business partner?
Yes, ma'am. His company is called JM Empire Media.
Okay. All right. What do you do with them?
Yes. So basically, we work coincide either with film work for our production with the TV show, with the radio show. Basically, we do promotions for art independent artists out there. We do showcases. Unfortunately, because of COVID, we do venues, but it got shut down. So we do for now, we do like online showcases or, you know, from my side, I do also, I have a magazine out. It's called Vero G Spotlight.
Slow down. You just put an album out. Yes. Okay. Look. We got all ranges of people listening here. Now you flying through this. Like you on a jet plane. Slow down, girl.
Okay.
I know you're excited. I'm excited for you, but you got to hit these key points, honey. So you got an album. What's the name of your album?
Yes. Okay. The new one is called Victory. It'll be out this month. It's my third album. I'm excited to put it out there.
What happened to our conversation, Chick? You ain't say no third album. You just gotta have an album out. Wait a minute.
I love it. No, because the second one's already out on all digital platforms. That was called The Rise of Vero G. That's been out for a couple of months now. So I think around the COVID time, I had to get my mind creative and stuff like just started writing my music. And the third one's already almost out this month.
Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, well, that is great. Look, now, you know, I want to hone all this in because I know how fantabulous you are. But we're trying to push all this into 30 minutes. So I know that you feel a little rushed. Don't be feeling rushed, honey. We don't finish it. We're going to come back next week. Stop tripping.
Okay, that's
we got time for all that. Look, I'm just saying. But look, you have an opportunity to this album. I'm really fascinated with the album because I've talked to you several times, honey, and you ain't told me about this was the third album. What was the first album? I'm lost now. What was the first one?
The first one, that was actually called Trials and Tribulations. I did that
like the book.
Years
okay.
ago. Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. And it's actually based on some of the personal stuff as well. But that one, it was, it's good. I only have hard copy at the time. I didn't really have it out for digital distribution. But I do have one or two singles from that album actually out on all platforms.
Okay.
All that stuff. So that's definitely some of them are available on that particular album. And then after that, the sophomore album, The Rise of Vero G, was right after that. And then this one now is the new edition for that. Yeah.
Awesome. Okay, so now we're going to slow this down.
Okay.
And we're going to tell everybody what platforms to go see you at. Let's start with your social media. Yes. How can they get in touch with you on social media?
Okay, so if you guys are interested or what I mentioned before, what we do, or just ask, check my music out, you guys can follow me on my Facebook. My artist page is Vero G, which is V-E-R-O, based G.
Vero G, V-E-R-O-G, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
You guys can also follow my website at www.verogmusic.com, where you can find all the content. Everything is available to make with news or just stuff that I'm doing and so forth with that. You also can follow me on Twitter, which is at VERO2884. I have so many sites, my gosh. Just the ones I'm I have a list here. But also, you can follow me as well on Instagram under Diva and Diamonds, DivaNDiamonds.
Mhm. Okay. All right.
Awesome.
Well, that is fantastic. And now this album, this third album, the release date is, what's the date again?
Yes. That's actually, you're the first to find out. I'm trying to push it before the end of this month. I won't put the exact date yet.
Okay. That's all right. We'll go to the website and check it out and stay pointed. That's all right.
Yes.
So when do you anticipate it coming out, though? Give us a time frame.
I would say maybe before the end of the month. I would say maybe October 28th. I'm just throwing it out there right now.
Mm-hmm. That's all right. Okay. Now we're going to end on the most important part. Veronica, I want you to tell me where you're from, where your people from, and what you're most proud of.
Oh, wow. Yeah, very proud. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Well, I'm from the Lower East Side. My background is more basically, I'm from my Spanish, my parents are Puerto Rican.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
basically, what my proudest moments is just talking to you guys right now. I mean, I have come such a long way, and I know maybe you said next week we'll talk more because I have another documentary I want to talk about, which is touches bases on my true beginnings, humble beginnings, and going through so many things in my life, and now I'm here, and I just want to be an example to people, I, even though I don't make it big, but I'm here, that's what matters, and I'm still trying, that's my proudest moment for me.
Look, you're doing a great job, so don't worry about it. You're doing fantastic.
You're doing just fine.
You know, I hope that this show actually inspires someone because, a lot of us feel as though once you can be in a situation of being a victim and turn out to be a victor.
Thank you.
And we need more stories like yours to be able to showcase that is the case that can happen to someone in their life. So, you keep doing what you're doing, girl. You are the most grindingest chick in the world.
Thank you so much.
I know that you Puerto Rican, but you act like you're Jamaican. I'm just trying to say.
I'm not, it's the Caribbean in me. I don't know what it is. It's in my blood. I don't know what it is. Oh, my God. I'm going to be crying here. Laughing out.
Well, everybody, we want to thank Ms. Veronica Gonzalez for sharing her everything with us. We are greatly appreciative of all of that, sweetheart. We'll have to have you come back on the show. We're going to have some other. I got Couch Chronicles, honey. You're going to have to be one of our female contestants on Couch Chronicles. So we're going to have you come back another time, okay?
Thank
now,
so
everybody,
much.
Please remember that we are actually in Ladies Night. So the show starts at 7 o'clock. I'm here at 7:30. And that I'm just saying, I'm so blessed that y'all are here and that you get to hear us all. And don't forget that up next, we have Ms. Tanya Maynard, Naturally Me, Naturally Free, and our very own Ms. Nina Taylor at 8:30, rounding us up for Ladies Night with Gospel Express. Now, Friday night, we have the date night with the Hilux discussing dating, marriage, and other topics at 9 p.m. And this Saturday at 11 a.m., we have Man Cave Dialogues with Eric Yarborough and Uncle Cliff. So we'd like to thank you so much for your time of being here today. Veronica, just tell everybody thank you. We love you for coming to the show and listening. And don't forget to go check her out because she is an awesome sister doing some things. Get off here, get behind and come on and join her, honey, because this girl don't even sleep. That's what I'm talking about.
Thank you so much, guys. I'm honored. And you guys are my night. Thank you so much. Thank you for listening.
You are very, very welcome. So to all of my single woman loves, I love you, and I'll see you back next week, Wednesday at 9 p.m. on Couch Chronicles, and again here on Ladies Night at 7:30. Love you and love you back. Please don't forget to friend me, and have a wonderful and safe week. Love you. Bye.
Don't let a man interfere. No, Miss on her own. Miss almost gone. Miss never let a man help her off her own stone. Keeping her heart protected. She never ever feel rejected. Little Miss apprehensive. Said, ooh, she fell in love. What is the feeling?
To the Love Radio Network worldwide. LoveRadioNetwork.com. Educational, inspirational, trending topics, and the hottest hits. With award-winning talk show hosts and personalities. And you made us number one. Thank you. Love Radio Network, building a network of love.